Are you killing me? 9 questions, that was the last question. Who do you think should be happy? And obviously, what did I answer? Me, man.
Yeah.
That's not what I asked. You know what I answered? There was a guy I was running for head boy when his name was Obake. I said, Obake should be head boy. You know why? Because I had doubt. Right there, in that moment, I knew if I said yes, I was going to be head boy. But then I started thinking, hey, I mean, you can say, there's 400 learners in the school. How am I going to manage this? Why do I have to take all the responsibility? Why? Why does it have to be me? Just because of doubt in the moment, I got scared. My fears came up. And in the moment, I said, oh my God, without even thinking twice. Because of doubt. And you know what happened? They made me deputy head coach of sport. I don't even play sport. That was the worst for me. Deputy head coach of something you don't even play. But in that, I learned and I lost something very good. I lost my name, Jason Noah. Big, you know when you walk into the school halls, they have those big, what do you call it? Boards. They have everybody's name since the school started. 1938, that's what we made. You guys get that, is that? I was the opportunity of my name being there because I had doubt. Looking at the person I am today, looking at my journey as it unfolds, that would have been a good start for me. I mean, what if next day I decided to shoot a documentary? I could have went all the way back to private. That would have said what type of person I am, why I am where I am today. But because of doubt, I missed that opportunity. For me, that was something big. But I learned that day. I learned that consistency is something you go from start to end. It doesn't matter if you're consistent yesterday, the day before, now, it's all about the moment. I was consistent with all my questions, except for one question. And that killed me, and I missed that opportunity. So I want you to know, when you get the strategy today, have consistency. Don't have doubt. If it breaks out for a bike, what do you do?
Bye.
What do you do?
Bye.
If it breaks out for yourself?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's alright. That's alright. So, anyway, Jason Law had to go to high school. Went to high school, and then, yeah, that's where it started now. That guy that was almost head boy, that guy that was a hard worker, he wasn't there anymore. I went to Ramon Woven High School, who knows me? That high school was that year in the newspaper for a fight, one of the biggest fights. And guess who was involved in the fight? Because me, that just tells what happened. From private, being that sweet kid, first year in high school, I got stabbed. Right here, above my bum, 3 centimeters away from my spinal cord from being disabled. I got stabbed. Okay, sharp. That was okay. I came back to school. 3 months later, boom, the teacher makes me angry. I was like, you, huge. Yeah, it was out of love. You know what happened? There was this guy, his name was Pupo. He's a friend of mine. So, he's one of the naughtiest kids ever. That guy had a Viagra when he came to school. I know. So you can imagine. So now, what our teacher would do is, she would come in the morning, put down a coffee, go for a smoke break outside, and then come back to teach him. But the main moral of the story is, in my high school journey, or in my school journey, I got to experience both. I mean, both sides of the fence. I was a good kid, I was having good marks, and then I was a naughty kid. I was really, really naughty in high school. I was so naughty up to a point my mom even wanted to chase me away from home in high school. And then I got chased away from Bangalore, went to Silverton High. Finished my machine. Yes, I do have machine for those of you that are wondering. Finished my machine there, and then I had to go and study. Now, good king, bad king, live both sides of the fence. Where's God going to take me now? Let's see. I had to go start to be a pilot. That's always been my dream. I always wanted to fly. But I had mad slip because I was naughty. Mad slip, you know you can't be a pilot, but mad slip. You need to pass it at least 80 something if you're going to do it in mad slip, right? So I passed in 67. I took that as an opportunity to take a gap year. I mean, our kids don't like books, so yo, gap year would be something. So I took a gap year. Took a gap year, and then, biggest mistake of my life. The day, we were going to finish the report, is the day I messed up my life. I got too excited, I think, because I made a girl. I made a girl pregnant. You know what it is to make somebody pregnant? Fresh out of high school. First year to adulthood. And there I am in this club bar. You know what that means? First, parents are cops. That's the number one starting point. Father's been in the police for 28 years. Mom was in the police for 16 years. What's going to happen to me if I tell them I'm going to go pray? Oh, it's good. Good. So, it happened. And she fell pregnant. I only found out she was pregnant 6 months into the pregnancy. I know. 6 months into the pregnancy, I found out. Now, I wasn't even dating, was part. She wasn't even my girlfriend. It's a one night stand that went the wrong way. But, it happened. And it's life. So, I had 3 months left to change my life. What do you do now? What's the way forward? Firstly, I'm not going to go study anymore. Then I'm out. I know I have to go look for a job. I know I have to be a man. So, I had to go tell my parents. I told my mom. She was mad. She was very mad. But she wasn't so mad because she knew my dad would be even more mad. So she had to control the anger for me. She was disappointed, but end of the day, it's reality and you go through. And then, boom, I had to go tell my dad. Now, one thing about my dad is, he always used to sit me down. He would tell me, use condom, do this. Never, don't sleep with a girl unless you're in a relationship. Don't. But what did I do? I wanted to learn it hard. I didn't listen to him. So, I went to tell him. The moment I told him, it was at night. The only word was, "Fear that you do." They didn't even say anything. They didn't say at me, nothing. And I knew immediately what I had to do. Next day I was out. Took everything out of my room. All my clothes, everything. I was out of the house. Because he told me that what was going to happen. If I made a girl pregnant. And I went to live in Babylon. You guys know Babylon? Yeah. Babylon, that's all. I went to live in Mandela, 2 weeks. 2 weeks, my friend of mine went to school with Insolvency. Left there, my mom would come check me, give me 150 rand, 100 rand. No, just to be like, hey, don't bother the people too much in the house. You know how it is living in my people's houses? It gets to a point that dish up you, you don't even want to eat. You feel guilty for just being. That was my situation. But because I had no choice, I had to be there. And then my mom came to me one day, she's like, hey, there's a police post open in Woodbury. You guys know Woodbury? Yeah, so she's like, hey, take a 200, come taxi, go to Woodbury, go right to the place, you're going to become a police officer. I was like, okay, yes, for me that's something. I have no money, I have nothing. It's a start. I know at least if I make 4,000 from the police, that's crampers, that's going to come to life. I don't know. It's a comfort zone. So that's what I want. Went to Woodbury. Boom, all the tears. You guess what happened? I failed. Now, at this point, I came back home to where I was living. Now, first day into adulthood, 18 years old. I'm expecting a baby boy. I don't have a job. My parents kicked me town. I'm learning about my friend's house. What else? How worse could it get? What else is there for me? It felt like at the moment life wasn't working out. And you know what it feels like when life isn't working out? You start getting depressed. You know what happens when you start getting depressed? You get suicidal thoughts. And that's what happened. I tried to commit suicide. Literally. Came back, I drank pills, and I just wanted to end it all. Because for me, that was the stroke. That was the end. I'm done with this life. You know how much it takes for a person to want to end their own life, knowing there's a baby boy on the way. You know how cowardly that must make you feel? But I did that because I saw no way out. I saw no greener pastures. Ahead of me, I saw nothing. And I knew my life was over. So I did it. And then boom, I went to hospital. Luckily. Next morning, I woke up in the hospital. I was never so happy. Because you know what happens if you commit suicide, right? You guys know what happens? You go away. Where do you go? To somewhere. You go to hell, boy. So, and then it happened. I woke up in hospital, and then right then, I decided something needed to change. I mean, I wanted to die, but then actually going through that and waking up alive, it changed my whole life. It changed the way I saw this life. Because I knew I had to hustle from that moment on. I knew it wasn't my time. It was my time, I would quit. But it wasn't. So what now? So, again, my dad comes, checks up on me, takes me back home. I'll be nice. 2 days goes past, I'm like, back to normal. My life is going to be nice. My dad is going to look after the baby, I'm going to go study. I walked it all out of my head. This is how it's going to go. 2 days later, boy, Muhammad, is it okay for me to be here? Yeah, it's okay. Shut up, go! And then, I was out again, in the streets again. Remember, my father's a police officer. He's seen worse than somebody trying to commit suicide. That's nothing for you. He's seen worse. So me coming here with those 3 to 10 hours, anyway, he wasn't happy. And then I was out of the street again. This time I went to Easter. And my cousin was driving in the back of me. That's when I started looking into training. My PA, now also my PA, she told me about training. She told me it's something to look into. But because she didn't understand, she was like, this is for young people. So I went for a course in safety. I went for a course. Now, the things they taught me at the course, the things I already taught myself on the internet. But the thing is, there wasn't a lot of traders back then. So you only have like 4 traders on Instagram or 5 traders. So that guy was the cheapest course that I could find. That's why I went to him. Now, the fact that he showed me how to throw a chain, but the fact that he showed me how to actually put it opened my mind, because he taught me something I already knew, but I didn't see it from the perspective that he sees. You understand? So, went back, I was like, yeah, this is it. Talked to my mom, I was like, I'm gonna start trading. I'm gonna make a million, I'm gonna be good. And then, she's like, oh, you sure? I'm like, yeah. So she took a big risk. She took a loan in the bank. Yeah, it's life. 14K loan. She came, parked outside, called me, it's like, here's the money. This money I'm about to give, this is the last one. This is where I said I tried. Because if this doesn't work out, I am a husband. He still needs to be happy. He has an own life. If this doesn't work out, what is it? We can pay by my calling, if it doesn't work out, I will pick share of my people. What can I do? So, took the risk. Deposited all the money into the trading account. And can you guess what happened?
Blew it.
Lost money. I blew the account all the way from $1,000 to $240. Then I was like, yo, this thing is not as easy. It's not as easy. That was my mentality. Because I thought I had $1,000, I'll be able to make money. That's not how it works in foreign trading. You must learn what you think. And then, $250, I took a break, I was like, whoa, this is going to kill me. If I lose this money, Ah, then I'm going to suicide again. And then I'm going for real this time. So, and then what happened is I started saving up. So I would work, do some jobs, and then boom, I had enough, I had about 2K. So there was a guy, his name was Ashley Hestonby. Yes. You guys know Ashley?
Yes.
If you don't know him, go Google him. You should know him, you know me. So he came to center. There was a little course in center. It was a 4-day course. It was 4,000. I only had 2K. I DM'd him like, hey bro, I'm hungry, bruh. I need this. I only have 2,000. Even if it means I must come for one day, can I please come? Because I saw through his Instagram page, his transparency, the way he grew his account. It was phenomenal. The student results. People with $50 deposits, making $400. I was like, yo, imagine me with $240, I can put up to $3,000 maybe. So that's what gave me the hope that I'm gonna vote for him. Then I went there. Day one, day two, I went. And that was it. I didn't have transport money. I came there, it's like, God, don't worry. I'm going to join the full course. They'll pay me back when nobody has money. And I said, 2 days. Couldn't go the rest of the 2 days. But 2 days was all I needed. Because what he taught me in the 2 days is something I took forever in my life. That's why I am where I am today. Because that 2 days changed my life. From 240, I grew my account back the same week. The days I had to go to class, I grew my account back all the way to 1,000. Took a break. For me, that wasn't a profit. That wasn't a loss. I just made back what I lost. And that's it. From next week, started growing steady, steady, steady. And then what happened 3 months later? Who knows? Who knows? I made a million, Baba. Yes, sir. In 3 months, managed to flip it to 1.3. 1.3. Same guy. The same guy was almost dead. The same guy was close to giving a ball about 1.3. And what do I do with this now? Yo, this is big. Like, what's my next step? Not everybody makes a million in 1 in 3 months. Yeah, that's hard work. It's dedication. But it's something that's possible if you're hungry enough to get it. So, then, there comes the part. I have to go back home. I have to go share. I have to go tell what's what. Mama, I'm a millionaire. So, and then I went back home. And then, obviously, my father didn't know about training and everything that's been going on. So he thought I was going to obviously come back, walk, you know, like each day. It's good. Ah, the boy pulled up in the A45. What forex trading actually is. Because remember,